This is the problem from complex number, and the question is number of complex number z such that mod of z minus 1 is equals to mod of z plus 1 is equal to mod of z plus I equals, and the options are 1, 2, infinite and 0. So let's see the solution of this problem. And to solve this problem, we have to consider z is equals to x plus I y. And on substituting the whole thing in this, we get x minus 1 whole square. Y square ka mod is equals to x plus 1 ka whole square plus y square ka mod, and x square plus I times y plus 1. Sorry, this will not be square. This will remain the x minus 1 plus y. So this is the mod of x minus 1 plus y. This is mod of x plus 1 plus y. And this is x plus I times y plus 1. And we know the formula of mod of any complex number. And we will write here this x minus 1 whole square plus y square, this will become I times y, sorry, in the root, and this will become x plus 1 whole square plus y square under root, and this will become an under root x square plus y plus 1 whole square. And now we will consider this equality as equation 1 and this equality as equation 2, because here we have two variables x and y. As you can see, this is x and y, so we have to solve the two equations which we'll get from here. And now solving first equation, we'll get x minus 1 whole square plus y square on squaring both sides, and here x plus 1 whole square plus y square. And solving this, this will we cancel out, and opening the bracket we get x square plus 1 minus 2x, and this will x square plus 1 plus 2x, and this will be cancel out, and the 1 also goes, and this will become 4x is equals to 0. This implies x is equals to 0, so we will get x is equals to 0, x is equals to 0 from this equation. And on solving the equation 2, on squaring both sides, we will get x plus 1 ka whole square plus y square is equals to x square plus y plus 1 whole square. And opening the bracket and solving, we get x square plus 1 plus 2x plus y square is equals to x square plus y square plus 1 plus 2y. X square goes, y square will also go, 1 also go, and this become 2x, 2, 2 also goes, this become x is equals to y. Okay, but from the first equation we get x is equals to 0 only, so from here x is equals to y, so y should also be 0. So the only solution is x is equals to 0 and y is equals to 0. So the only equation is 0 plus I times 0, which means 0. Means z is equals to 0 is only the complex number which satisfies this equation, and the option, and the correct option is 1. Here's the next problem from the function chapter, and the question is, if f is the function defined in the R to R satisfying the functional relation f of 2x plus 3 plus f of 2x plus 7 is equals to 2 for all x belonging to R, then the period of fx is, and the option are 2, 4, 8 and 16. So first of all, what are the periodic functions? Periodic functions are those functions which repeats itself in regular interval of time. So now how we solve this problem? Let us see. So here they are asking for period. It means this function means the fx function can repeat itself in a regular interval. So first of all, we have to replace x by x plus 1 in the given equation. So we will get f of 2 times x plus 1 plus 3 plus f of 2 times x plus 1 plus 7, which is equals to 2. And this will become f of 2x plus 5 plus f of 2x plus 9 is equals to 2. Now we will substitute x by x plus 2 in the given equation. We will get f of 2 times x plus 2 plus 3 plus f of 2 times x plus 2 plus 7 equals to 2. And this becomes f of 2x plus 7 plus f of 2x plus 11 is equals to 2. And here we have f of 2x plus 7, and here we will also have f of 2x plus 7. So now let us name this equation as 1, and this is 2. And to find the relation among them, we have to subtract 1 minus, means equation 1 minus 2. And on solving this, here is f of 2x plus 7, and here is also f of 2x plus 7, and on subtracting, this will cancel out. And in the left hand side, we will get f of 2x plus 3 minus f of 2x plus 11 is equals to 0, because RHS on the both the equation is 2, and 2 minus 2 is 0. And we can write this as f of 2x plus 3 is equals to f of 2x plus 11. So from here we can compute this, that f of 2x plus 3 is equals to f of 2x plus 11. This means that after moving 8 more in x-axis, we will get the same result, because here is 3 and here is 11. So the period of, and here we can see that this is 2x, not x. So period of 2x, period of f of 2x will be 11. Because this is 2x plus 3 and 2x plus 11. So what will be the period of fx? This is very simple, and the period of fx will be 16. Because if f of 2x is equals to 8, then the period of fx is equals to 16, and the correct option is D. So by this we can solve this type of problems. This is the problem from trigonometric equation, and the question is, the general solution of trigonometric equation 1 plus sine cube x plus cos cube x is equals to 3 by 2 sine 2 x is, and the options are given below. So first of all, we have to manipulate this equation, because this seems like be very tricky. So now with the help of algebra, we will try to reduce this equation. So the equation is 1 plus sine cube x plus cos cube x is equals to 3 by 2, and by expanding sine 2x, we get 2 sine x cos x. And from algebra, we are knowing that if a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equals to 3 times a, b, c, this implies a plus b plus c is equals to 0. 2 will cancel out. And by comparing this from this, we get a is equals to 1, b is equals to sine x, and c is equals to cos x. And the whole thing is written in this way: a cube plus b cube plus c cube is equals to 3 times a, which is 1, b sine x, c cos x. So directly we can write that 1 plus sin x plus cos x is equals to 0 from this. A plus B plus C is equals to 0 if A cube plus B cube plus C cube is equals to 3 times ABC. Now, we will get this equation, and to find the values of x, now we will solve this. So, sin x plus cos x will be minus 1. Here are two terms, sin x plus cos x, and now I am going to reduce in only the single term in the form of cos x. So, on multiplying by root 2 and dividing by root 2, we will get this is equals to minus 1, and this will be 1 by root 2 sin x plus cos x by root 2 is equals to minus 1, and when root 2 comes here, this will become minus 1 by root 2, and in the place of 1 by root 2 we can write cos pi by 4 or sin pi by 4. So this will become sin pi by 4 sin x plus cos pi by 4 into cos x, which is equals to minus 1 by root 2. And we know the expression, the reduced expression of this, which is equals to cos of x minus pi by 4. The cos formula of cos of a minus b, which is equals to minus 1 by root 2. And the general equation of cos x is equals to alpha is x is equals to 2n pi plus minus alpha. And from here we'll get, in the place of x, we'll have x minus pi by 4, x minus pi by 4, and 2n pi plus minus minus 1 by root 2. In the radian form we will have 3 pi by 4, and the value of x on transferring minus x pi by 4 to this way, we'll get x is equals to 2n pi plus minus 3 pi by 4 plus pi by 4. This is the final result of x, which is 2n pi plus minus 3 pi by 4 plus pi by 4, and from the options given, the correct option is A. This is the question from complex number, and the question is, if mod of 1 plus 4i minus 2 to the power minus x is less than or equal to 5, where I is equals to root of minus 1, then x belongs to which interval? And the options are given below. Now let us see how to solve this problem. So the given thing is mod of 1 plus 4i minus 2 to the power minus x is less than or equal to 5. And this is mod, and we know the formula of mod, and this will become 1 minus 2 to the power minus x whole square plus 4 times whole square under the square root, and which is equals to 5. On squaring both sides, we get 1 minus 2 to the power minus x whole square plus 16 less than equal to 25, and on manipulating the things we will get this will become 9, and this is 1 minus 2 to the power minus x whole square is less than equal to 9. On taking a square root we will get 1 minus 2 to the power minus x, but not only the 1 minus 2 to the power minus x, we'll apply mod, because we know that on taking the square root of the square we will be very careful, because here we'll get the mod of 1 minus 2 to the power minus x, which is less than or equal to 3, and we know how to solve this inequality. Mod of x less than or equal to alpha is x belongs to the minus alpha to alpha. So on applying this concept we'll get 1 minus 2 to the power minus x is less than or equal to 3 and greater than or equal to minus 3. So now we have to just solve this inequality to find the values of x. So we'll get here is minus 4, minus 2 to the power minus x, and this will become 2. And on removing the minus sign from here, we will change the inequality sign, and this will become 4. This will become 2 to the power minus x, and this will become minus 2. So the range of 2 to the power minus x will be from minus 2 to the 4. But as we know, the graph of a to the power and a to the any power where a is greater than 0, it will be never be negative. So we can write this as 2 to the power minus x will be from 0 to 4. Okay, and we can also write 4 as 2 to the power 2, and here is 2 to the power minus x, and how we write 0 is the main idea, and this we can write 0 as 2 to the power minus infinity, because on writing this we will get 1 upon 2 to the power infinity, which is 0, not 0 but exactly approaches to 0. So here we will get 2 to the power 2 minus x 2 to the power minus infinity. So the value of x lies between minus 2 to infinity, because here is minus x, so we'll change the sign and we'll get the final result of x, that is closed interval minus 2 comma to the infinity, because here is an equality sign, so we have to put closed interval, but for infinity we'll never put a closed interval, because infinity is not a number, it just a concept. So the correct answer is D. Here is the problem from vector chapter, and the question is, let A vector is 2i plus j minus 2k, B is I plus j. If C is a vector such that A dot C is equals to mod of C, mod of A plus C is equals to 2 root 3, and angle between this is 30 degree, then what is the value of this? So now let us solve this problem. So first of all, we would find out the A cross B. A is 2i plus j minus 2k, and B vector is I plus j. So A cross B, I, j, k, and this is 2, 1, minus 2, this is A vector, and here we will write the same thing, and here we will also write the same thing. This is 1, this is 1, this is 0, because this is a B vector. This is also 1, 1, 0, write the same thing here, just like above. This is, and this is a better trick to find the cross product between the two vectors. And now let us see how to solve this. This will become 2i minus 2, this will become minus 2j, 2 minus 1, this will become k. So the cross product between A cross B is this, and the mod of A cross B is root of 4 plus 4 plus 1, which is equals to root 9, which is equals to 3. So the mod of A cross B comes out to be 3. So here we can write mod of A cross B is equals to 3. Now let us see the things which are given in the question, and the two things are A dot C is equals to mod of C, and the mod of A plus C is equals to 2 times root 3. So with the help of that we will solve the question, and this is mod of A plus C is equals to 2 times root 3, and on squaring both sides we get a vector square plus C vector square plus 2 times A dot C, and here we will get 12. And the mod of A square, with the help of the given vector A, we can find out, and this will be root whole square 4 plus 1 plus 4 plus mod of C square, as it is, because we have nothing to know about the C vector, but we know the dot product between A dot C, which is equals to the mod of C. So we will write here mod of C is equals to 12. This is the equals 9, 12. Okay, this will become 9 plus c square plus 2 times c is equals to 12. And on manipulating the things, we will get is minus 3 is equals to 0. And on solving the given quadratic in terms of c vector, we will get the values of mod of c is equals to 1 and mod of c is equals to minus 3. But mod can never be negative, so this is not permissible, and we will take only mod of c is equals to 1. But we have to find the mod of a cross b dot c. So with the help of the given a cross b, the angle between a cross b and c, we will find the thing, and let's see what will be the, and we know that the dot product of two vector is mod of a mod of b into the cosine of the angle between them. And if we write a in place of a dot b, a cross b and c, we'll get a cross b dot c is equals to mod of a cross b into mod of c into cosine of 30 degree, because the 30 degree is the angle between a cross b and c. And we will find the mod of a cross b dot c, which is equals to mod of a cross b is 3, as we find out earlier, and mod of c is equals to 1 from this quadratic equation. Mod of c is equals to 1, and on substituting this, and on substituting the value of cos 30, which is equals to the root 3 by 2, the value comes out to be 3 root 3 by 2. So the final value of a cross b dot c is equals to 3 root 3 by 2, and the question asks the same thing. So the correct option is b, which is equals to 3 root 3 by 2.